everyone. Welcome back to Mind Body Tonic, and this is Dr. Sita with you again. A few decades ago, diabetes mellitus, hypertension, and other such diseases were all seen in people over the age of 50 or so. But these days, the scenario is very different. Many youngsters are suffering from all these illnesses due to various lifestyle factors, lack of exercise, dietary imbalance, stress both at the workplace and in the family, and various hormonal imbalances. In women, the incidence of PCOS or polycystic ovarian syndrome is alarmingly on the rise. Many women with PCOS develop impaired glucose tolerance and diabetes mellitus sooner or later. A large number of women with PCOS who become pregnant develop gestational diabetes during pregnancy. Many women who do not develop PCOS are also seen to develop impaired glucose tolerance these days. And women who enter pregnancy with an impaired glucose tolerance or diabetes mellitus are at an increased risk of having babies who develop various congenital malformations. Let us have a quick look at the various congenital malformations that these babies born to mothers with impaired glucose tolerance can develop. One is cardiac defects. Cardiac defects are the most common defects encountered in these babies. The incidence of cardiac defects is 4 times more when compared to the general population. Atrioventricular septal defect, coarctation of aorta, hypoplastic left heart syndrome, all these are the ones that are commonly seen. Two, various skeletal defects. The incidence of sacral agenesis or caudal regression is 100 to 200 times more in babies of women with uncontrolled diabetes mellitus in the first trimester of pregnancy. Shortening of the thigh bone, that is the femur bone, and various other skeletal abnormalities are also associated with this. Three, neural tube defects. Anencephaly and various other neural tube defects are also more commonly seen in babies of women born to diabetic mothers. 4. Abnormalities of the urogenital system. These are also more common in such babies. For example, renal agenesis, that is absence of one or both kidneys, duplication of one or both ureters, that is a tube which connects the kidney with the urinary bladder, that can cause a lot of problems, hydronephrosis, that is enlargement of the kidney, hypospadias, where the urethral meatus does not open at the tip of the penis but beneath, underneath the penis at various points. 5. Abnormalities of the gastrointestinal tract, duodenal atresia, anorectal atresia, atresia of other parts of the small intestine are all more commonly seen in such babies. Atresia means an abnormal narrowing of a passage or an opening in the body. 6. Facial abnormalities. Facial abnormalities like cleft lip, cleft palate, etc. are more common in babies born to diabetic mothers. 7. Multiple malformations. In addition to the individual malformations which I mentioned just now, many of such babies are prone to develop multiple malformations affecting various systems in the body. Fortunately, many babies who develop malformation get aborted early in the pregnancy. Otherwise, it would be so difficult for both the baby and for the parents, isn't it? Now, please don't get scared or alarmed after listening to all this. I do have a good news for you. The good news is, when a woman enters pregnancy with her blood sugar levels all under proper control, then the chances of her developing a baby with any type of congenital malformation is not at all increased when compared to the general population. So it is imperative that each and every woman checks her blood sugar level before attempting pregnancy. And in case there is any abnormality, ensure that the blood sugar levels are brought down to normal levels before pregnancy is attempted. We will discuss in a separate video about the test that needs to be done and when it needs to be done, etc. And if the blood sugar level is maintained within the normal limits throughout the pregnancy, then the chances of the mother or the baby developing any sort of complications is also greatly reduced. We will discuss about all these also in 2 or 3 videos. Please do share this information and pass it on. Till I see you again with another video, take care of yourself and your loved ones and stay blessed.